name is Ron Rolett.
My name is Karin Rolett.
We live in a very rural place in western North Carolina. We do a lot of walking around here. We heat with wood, and so we have to split logs and we have to carry wood in. It's a fairly physical lifestyle. I've had hypertension for a number of years, and because of that and my age, my primary care doctor felt that I should have an ultrasound.
The real slammer came last year when he got the diagnosis of a much enlarged aorta. Kindly known as the widowmaker, which does not make your family feel very good.
I talked with a couple of doctors about procedures and got a second opinion actually at Johns Hopkins.
The abdominal aorta, usually the aorta below the kidney arteries, starts to enlarge with aging or with atherosclerosis, and over time the normal diameter of the aorta, which is about the size of a garden hose, will enlarge to closer to the size of a can of soda or even larger, and at that level we call it an aortic aneurysm.
There were two basic options. One was the fenestrated graft, which would be put on the inside of the aorta, or the other option was to actually open me up through the abdomen.
It was pretty clear to us that we wanted to go with a fenestrated graft, mainly because of the invasiveness of an open procedure and the length of recovery. And especially since we were traveling away to have this procedure done, the idea of having to stay away longer, having a more complicated return home, and then a longer and more complicated recovery made it pretty clear.
I met and talked to Dr. Black, and I was very impressed and decided that's where I wanted to have my surgery. I got a call that it had arrived in Baltimore, so my wife and I went up there immediately. And 2 days later, I was admitted to the hospital for surgery.
The key about the fenestrated stent graft technology is that the stent itself, instead of being a straight cylinder that is placed inside the aorta, it is now a cylinder that has two or three individual windows drilled or fabricated into the device. Those little windows will line up with the kidney arteries or the artery that supplies the intestine and allows us to bring the stent higher up the abdominal aorta where the aorta is healthier. So a healthier piece of aorta with a more normal diameter is going to give us the best long-term outcome. Placing the stent was very straightforward. It is in most patients and it will fit into the patient perfectly and the procedure goes smoothly. And that's exactly how it went for Dr. Rolett.
Within 2 weeks or so after I was pain-free and able to walk a mile a day and increase that to a couple miles a day by the third week. Now that I'm 3 months post-surgery, I'm doing everything that I ever did back when I was in my prime. We were quite certain that this was going to work out well, and it did.